Let's take a closer look at the range of Powermaster zoom binoculars from Helios. This is really a very thoroughgoing range of high power binoculars, with starting at the 10 by 30 by 60 model, we move through to the 12 by 36 by 70 millimeter objective model, and then we go through to Big Bertha here, which is the giant of the range. That's 13 to 40 times magnification and whacking 80 millimeter object glasses. I'm actually going to use that one as our exemplar, so I'm going to show you all the features of this binocular by actually looking closely at the 80 mil binocular. Nice little feature here, we've got a tandem or a binary cap, dust cap, that's the same on all of them for the eyepieces. One of the first things to notice about this binocular is this very modern single cell body design. We've got very few seams on it, putting it together. The body has been very closely molded to the internal optics. That means that this binocular is going to perform well in terms of rough usage situation. It's by no means shockproof or anything like that, but it's a very well made binocular for a long service life. Another nice feature is the big focuser that you can see there, ideal for gloved hands. I particularly like, as a glasses wearer, the very deep eye relief that this binocular sports with these screw down click stop eye cups here. They're also in soft rubber, so it makes a very comfortable connection with your eyewear. Another unusual feature, and in fact I can't think of any other binocular that's got this, are these very easy to adjust. You can adjust them with a single fingertip. The individual diopter control on the left eye of this binocular. That really is a very unusual feature. Makes it very easy to adjust the binocular and get a perfect fused view for personal adjustment of your eyesight. Another good feature is the very easy select zoom control on the binocular. You can see that I can adjust that with one finger going across from 13 times all the way across to 40. Okay, one tiny little niggle. One thing I don't like about these binoculars are the tethered lens caps. I think it's a great idea on paper and it's a great idea in the store. Everyone thinks, yeah, great, I'm not going to lose the lens caps. But the truth is, in the wind, they just kind of flap around and that actually makes them rather annoying. But the good news is, they just come right off. You can either cut away the tethered part or simply remove them like this and shove them in your pocket, which is what I would normally do with it. This is a good weight binocular for an 80mm. I don't think I've come across an 80mm quite this compact before. I know it's not a small binocular, not by any means, but when you compare it with other 80mm on the market, it's well got a very, very, very small footprint for this size of binocular. And this is really the same for the whole range. If you look at the overall body size of the 70, it's got a very, very small body profile, and so through to the 60 as well. So this really is a very modern design binocular. I like the way they've put the the strap, the neck strap points on here. Don't know as I'd want this round my neck for too long, a binocular of this size, but they certainly have put provision for an neck strap on here as well. But it comes in a good case. The quality of the view with the binocular, frankly, is superb. They are some of the best zoom binoculars we've seen. We've certainly not seen a range of zooms with this kind of size objectives on them. Remember, the big one here is 80 millimeters with a magnification range of 13 to 40. That really is a big binocular. Easy to hand hold at the 13 times end. Really would need some kind of stabilizing at the 40 times end if you were going to do any more than take a quick peek at maybe the insignia on a plane or that kind of thing. This is quite a heavy binocular to hold. You might want some kind of support with it. As a compromise, the 70 mil here is probably the favoured one for plane spotting, simply because it's a significantly lighter glass. I don't think you need the 80 mil, so the 70 mil here I think would really be ideal. It's got a range here of 12 to 36 times magnification, giving you actually a generous field of view as well. So picking up a moving target when it's moving in the air isn't going to be too difficult at all. We've got a field of view here of 52 meters down to 24 meters at the high power end of things. Again, you can see we've got those same tethered eye cups on there as well. Very comfortable binocular hold and very easy to use. That's the full range there from Helios. That's the Powermaster range of binoculars. For high powered viewing, ideal for long range viewing of any kind, and I think a very strong contender for plane spotting as well.